Thank you. Olaf the fisherman was young, in love with life, in love with the sea, and in love with music. The sea seemed to still its murmur as it listened to his song, and even the fish danced with joy. But Olaf's task was to bring home a full net, for they lived in a land ruled by a cruel sorcerer, a mighty giant who swept down from the sky to demand tribute from his subjects, offerings from the sea. Olaf's mother wept when she saw that her son's basket was again empty, and they had nothing to appease the anger of the great sorcerer. With a mighty roar, the heavens parted and Fëanor appeared. Everywhere he saw fires lit awaiting his arrival. But by the cottage of Olaf and his mother, there was nothing.
Mercy, O great sorcerer.
Idle youth, where is my offering? Why have you not done homage?
Have pity. He shall bring a large offering tomorrow.
Tomorrow then, or he dies.
Early the next morning, before the sun rose.
Goodbye, Mother.
Oh, my son, I am afraid.
Do not worry. Tonight, when I return, my nets shall be full.
Here, take your father's belt for luck.
Mother, now I cannot fail.
Farewell, my son.
But thought kind to a day. He caused a dark, the heavens were black, and the fish swam by lamplight. Up sailed on. Not far from his stormed boat, a beautiful mermaid raised her song to the angry heavens. She was Luna, queen of all the creatures that lived in the sea, and she alone had the power to soothe the wrath of the terrible Fëanor. Was happy, for her world was at peace again. Then, suddenly, she saw an intruder and dove quickly into the deep to save her friends. Olaf drew in his net, thinking in his ignorance that it was a bountiful catch.
Oh!
I am Luna, the queen of the sea.
Luna?
Why do you spread your cruel nets for my subjects? Can you not live in peace with the creatures of the sea? What harm do they do you?
Oh, rare and beautiful queen, I can do no other. I would please you, but Fëanor demands his offering, and I fear to die.
You need fear Fëanor no longer, for my song can soothe his anger. If you promise to spare my creatures, I swear that you shall come to no harm.
Olaf thought for a moment, and then extended his hand. Thank you.
Thank you. Shut the door.
Too small.
Help! Help! Help!